In South Africa, there's literally no fear of the law. Police just don't care. Government is turning a blind eye. Children are being abducted. Women are being raped. Even an 8-month-year-old baby was raped. There's some crazy stuff happening in South Africa right now.
Way of life as cute. Even if hunted.
Assalamu alaikum, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's video is going to be about explaining and exposing all the craziness that's happening in South Africa. You see, our local medias aren't really doing a great job covering it, but alhamdulillah, through the power and access of social media, we are literally well informed, even if the general media doesn't cover it. So here's a few things that are actually taking place in South Africa that you need to be informed about. There is a ton of xenophobic attacks happening against foreigners in that country. So many incidents and reports of burning people alive, stabbing people, trucks being set on fire. Looting and crimes have been off the walls. They even burned down a masjid. People are being burned alive. Women are being sexually assaulted, raped, and even killed. And during this whole time, government is turning a blind eye. Women are being raped and no one seems to be batting an eyelid. And it's happening so much and so often that women have gathered together and started to demand that the death penalty be reinstated. An 8-month-old baby was raped. I want you to wrap your head around the statement that I just said. A 6-year-old girl was abducted and kidnapped. Even a famous female boxer was killed by her own boyfriend. And what set everything off on social media was almost a week-long abduction of a young 19-year-old student who completely disappeared off the face of the earth. Later on, they found out that she was raped and killed by a 42-year-old post office worker. This young lady literally went to the post office to deliver a package to drop off something to be sent. And guess what happens? The electricity is out. The man tells her to come back later. And when she does return back, he sees her, locks the door shut, and begins to rape her. She's fighting back. And he takes a blunt object and smashes it on her head, knocking her unconscious while he continues to rape her. Upon this happening, he then realizes he's went too far. So he decides to kill her and bury her in an unmarked grave. This is all happening in South Africa. Major news stations are not talking about it. When the killer was brought in front of the higher court, he literally turned around to the audience and grinned. I want that to sink in because we've recently seen something very similar. Women are literally afraid to leave their house. Mothers are afraid to send their daughters out to school. Women are not even going to work right now because they're asking themselves a question. Am I next? I want to tell you that Islam has a solution. But I'm sorry, I'm not going to tell you that. Because the way we're practicing Islam doesn't represent any type of solution. How can we help them when we're dealing with our own crisis such as honor killings? What made the companions so powerful and able to take over the globe and spread Islam was they have already mastered their salah. They have already made sure they were all aligned according to the sunnah. So now they were able to go out and do real things for the deen. But our basic problem is trying to even pray salah. We're still struggling to wake up for fajr. We're still struggling to even pray. How can we take over the globe and spread Islam when we haven't even gained basic control over our obligations to Allah? We're so focused on spending our energy on some minor things that we all should have mastered by now, that we can't take major leaps and strides in the direction of Allah to spread His deen and do right by this world because we're still struggling on some basic low-level stuff. Like I said, Islam has a solution, but look what we're doing, bro. With all this craziness happening in those countries, with governments not paying attention and riots happening and looting happening, it is still not being covered in the media. And this just goes to show you that they genuinely don't want you to know or care. They want you to care only about yourself. They want you to care about the latest Air Jordan releases or the latest Samsung phone releases or the latest iPhone releases. They want you to be so selfish and self-centered that you literally don't bat an eyelid or don't care about anyone besides yourself. And if we as an ummah, as a nation of humanity, do not care about others who are suffering and we ignore them because
at least it ain't me and my family,
then it's only a matter of time before it happens to you, your family, and your country. JazakAllah for watching, guys. I appreciate your love and support. Make sure you tell me in the comment section below if you already knew what's happening in South Africa, if I missed anything as well. Of course, please drop a dua for them and the women and people suffering in that country. Dua is free and it's a powerful tool. We gotta use it correctly. And please share this message. Share it with people to raise awareness about what's happening, because and even in these countries, Muslims are still suffering. And until next time, I'm out.